early evening celebration of music, some good piano and guitar, and wonderful to have Allan and Michael with us. Many of you from our congregation know Michael from when he's been here preaching, and a lot of you are here because of him tonight, and that's great to have you come. And Allan told me it's his first time in this church, and it's true, I guess, but we've met through mutual friends along the way. It's good to be able to enjoy this gift of music on a Sunday afternoon. What we try to do with our Jazz Vespers is just to make it a light gathering, just to enjoy the gift of music, enjoy each other, wrap it with a little bit of prayer, and I'll bring a short reflection, and then afterwards you can talk to each other and see how it was for you. So it's good to be here together, and I would ask you to, if you've all gotten one of the programs, the dark print is yours, and the light print is mine. And so we start with this call to blessing through God's presence. Your embrace is an elixir for my flourishing.
Your listening is a balm for my confusion.
Your wisdom is a light for my considerations.
Your companionship is life and all its fullness.
And for all the fullness that we are going to receive tonight, it's packaged in some good music. And so we're going to ask for a little bit more right now.
When I put the poster on Facebook for this event that we've been looking forward to, I had mentioned that we're going to do a Beatles tune, and somebody was hoping that I might reveal what that was now. But I will say, this song is well known from them performing it before the Queen. And they did so 50 years ago, coming up. And Allan and I decided that anything coming on to 50 years merits inclusion into the jazz canon. So here we go.
December last year that we got started back up again. So I was fascinated to find out how many books about jazz and faith that there were written. And a lot of them are written through church lenses. And so I have some sources that I can pull on. And so some of the prayers here are some of those sources. So let's join in our prayer of inspiration and renewal. You desire to sanctify your whole creation, dear family of Creator, including and especially us human beings. We are endowed by you through being created with the capacities to bless each other in the places to which you have summoned us to partner with you in nourishing, flourishing life.
We are equipped by you with tools to bless this world, tools to be used.
It swings to the redemptive melodies and harmonies of love, joy,